Hi.
Hi.
You already finished? ¿Ya habían acabado su clase? ¿Apenas o apenas estaban
Apenas.
terminando?
Sí, apenas.
Ok, porque veo que tardan. ¿Qué clase era?
Matemáticas.
Con el profe Irving. Ok, vamos a esperar un ratito más. A ver si se empiezan a conectar tus compañeros.
Hi.
Hi. Okay, we are going to wait a few minutes. Do your partners finish? Okay. We almost be there. Okay, goal experience, unit one. We already saw that. The present simple, let's look at. When do we use the present simple? Someone of you remember that?
Yes.
Yes, tell me. When do we use the present simple? In which condition?
Para decir cuando hace, para decir hechos, rutinas o hábitos.
Very good, but now repeat in English. Ana, repeat the same you say, but in English.
I don't know how say hechos in English.
Facts.
Okay. The present simple.
You try. The present simple is used in what?
Is to in acts. Acts.
Facts. Okay, it's using facts and habits, okay?
Okay. Es que me falta un poquito de vocabulario.
Don't worry, that we are here. Hi. Okay, how do we make sentences in present simple? Okay, we already see this.
Estoy con mi papá. Está mal dicho, ¿no?
Okay, boy. Continue. Look at the examples and complete the patterns for the positive, negative, and question forms with the boxes below. Okay.
Hi.
With this,
I work.
Huh? Mm-hmm. What's up, Alejandro? Luis Alejandro, what's up? What did you say?
Sorry, teacher.
Okay. Continue. With auxiliary do and doesn't, auxiliary do and does, bear and bear, okay? With this part, we have to complete this one. So, in the first example, that is, I work in a shop and my brother works in bakery, I give you that, okay? What is that? I work in a shop and my brother works in a bakery. Here is the subject. Aquí vemos al sujeto plus the verb or verb with S. Más el verbo o el verbo con agregándole S, ES o esto, ¿ok? Y vemos el ejemplo aquí arriba. I work, el sujeto y el verbo. I work, subject and the verb. Ah, y aquí adelante vemos my brother works. Entonces es el sujeto y el verbo agregándole una S, ¿ok? ¿Por qué se le agrega una S? Porque es tercera persona, he, she, it. Y cada que tenemos he, she, it, vamos a agregar una S. ¿Sí se entiende? Do you understand? Everyone understand?
Yes.
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 Okay. So, in the next exercise, please complete, help me, you can help you with the exercise. I don't eat meat and my mother doesn't eat fish. With this sentence, what is the right option? Auxiliary don't, doesn't, auxiliary do, does, verb infinitive or verb infinitive. Come on, solve this problem. Copy in your notebook and solve that problem. Check the pattern. Check in el patrón, okay? In the sentence. Check in el patrón en el enunciado. I don't eat meat and my mother doesn't eat fish. So, what happened there? And when you finish, Okay, did you finish?
¿Qué te cambia?
Hola, profe. ¿Qué tenemos que hacer?
Copy and solve the problems that appear in your screen.
Okay.
Me saqué el internet.
Disculpe la tardanza, profe. Es que no me agarraba ni la contraseña ni el IT.
Teacher?
Yes?
I have a doubt. I can repeat the auxiliary?
The auxiliary verb? The auxiliary verb is a verb to do. To do for present simple.
In the negative sentence, I can repeat the auxiliary or I only can use the two options.
Okay, you have here in your screen auxiliary done or doesn't. You can use both of them. Okay.
Okay.
Actually, you need to use both of them. Okay, boys and girls, did you finish? Spanish.
Finish.
Anyone else?
Finish.
Perfect.
Finish, teacher.
Perfect.
Finish.
Okay, let's check. I'm going to put the answer and check if you are right. The first one is subject, auxiliary done by Dawson. And verb in the okay? And the other is the auxiliary. And the verb in the This is the structure. Esa es la estructura del presente simple. Okay? ¿Quién la tuvo bien? Rapidito. That is the structure. Esa es la estructura, ¿ok? ¿Alguien la tuvo bien?
Tenemos después que completarla, ¿no?
Exacto. Ok, Carla, you are right. Corrijan. Esa es su estructura. Esa estructura es la que vamos a estar estudiando todo el tiempo, ¿ok? Para el presente simple. With this structure, we are going to make sentences. Con esa estructura, vamos a hacer enunciados. En positivo, en negativo, y para hacer preguntas. Ok, aquí donde dice question, al inicio dice Q word. Ok, question word. ¿Cuál es la palabra para hacer la pregunta? Es el verbo auxiliar. Do, o question mark, do, ¿sí? Vamos a usar el verbo auxiliar do or does, así como lo vemos aquí en pantalla, el verbo auxiliar do and does, then, the subject, luego la persona, and then the verb, ¿ok? Aquí hay un claro ejemplo, do, es el verbo auxiliar, a ver si lo podemos ver en pantalla, luego viene el sujeto, you, do you, y luego el verbo, leave, ok, do you leave her? Ok, I leave her. ¿Sí se entiende dónde, cómo está el asunto en la estructura?
Yes.
Yes.
Perfect, ok, continue with the exercise. Okay, this is simple, right? With third person, he, she, it, we are going to add an S to the verb. Okay? And the auxiliary verb, do, change for does, or with the negative doesn't, change, with third person, okay? Todo lo que son terceras personas, he, she, it, cambia. Con he, she, it, le agregamos una S al verbo en la cuestión positivo. Cuando hacemos enunciados negativos, el verbo cambia de don't a doesn't. Nada más con estos tres, he, she, it. Y para hacer preguntas, siempre es con do, a excepción de estos tres, ¿no? He, she, it, vamos a hacer la pregunta, la vamos a comenzar con does. All clear until here? ¿Todo claro hasta aquí? All clear until here? Okay. Again, we only change or add to the verb in the present simple in the third person singular, he, she, it, okay? Look, this is example. I work in a shop. They work in a shop. You work in a shop. Okay? Doesn't change. But what happened with he, she, or it? He works in a bakery, ¿ok? Aquí ya cambia, aquí le agregamos una S porque es he. again, in the negative and question form, in the third person singular, he, she, it, we use doesn't or does, okay? Or does not. Vamos a usar en terceras personas, he, she, it, ya sea para hacer negaciones, la contracción doesn't o la palabra completa does not, okay? O para hacer preguntas, does. The infinitive of a verb is the form you find in a dictionary. Ok, cuando hace referencia al verbo en infinitivo, significa que es el verbo tal cual. Some question, yes, no. Didn't have a question word. Ok, things to consider. Okay, things to consider. We know now, ahora lo sabemos, now, that in the positive, in the third person, he, she, it, we add s, es, or ies to the verb, okay? But when do we add s? Pero ¿cuándo vamos a agregar a cada uno de ellos? Okay, let's to check. Copy these grammar rules, please. Copien esta regla gramatical, estos recuadros azules, to your notebook. Y aquí en el notebook nos dice que vamos a agregar S a los verbos más comunes. En el ejemplo, she drives a car, al verbo drive le agregamos S. He works in a bank, al verbo work se le agregó una S para conjugarlo en terceras personas. He, she, it. Ok, and we add ES, agregamos una E y una S. With verbs ending in O, double S, X, CH, or SH. Cuando nuestro verbo termina en O, doble S, X, CH, o SH, agregamos ES, ¿ok? The example, she does exercise. Al verbo do, le agregamos ES. Para que sea does. En el siguiente ejemplo, he catches the bus. Al verbo catch, le agregamos ES y lo conjugamos catches. Ok. But, what happened with my verb ending in Y? ¿Qué pasa cuando mi verbo termina en Y? Ok, elimino la Y, la cambio por una I latina y agregamos ES. Dos ejemplos. The baby cries a lot. El verbo cry. Eliminamos la Y, la cambiamos por IS. Ok. Cry, cryeth. El verbo fly, igualmente, eliminamos la Y, lo cambiamos por IS y queda como flies. El ejemplo de arriba, she flies a lot for work. ¿Sí se entiende? Do you understand?
Yes. Yes.
Perfect. Copy the grammatical rules yes. To your notebook. And when you finish, tell me. Thank you.
Finish.
Finish.
Finish. Finish, teacher.
Okay, perfect. But do you understand the grammatical rule? ¿Sí entienden la regla gramatical?
Yes.
Okay, okay, boys, frequency adverbs. Tell us how often or frequently we do something. For example, I usually do exercise every day. Okay? Frequency adverbs we use to make how often or frequently we do something. Usually is an adverb of frequency. It tells us how often the girl does exercise. Okay, in this square, in this schedule, we are going to watch the different frequencies, okay? So, usually, not often, always, not usually, sometimes, often, and never, okay? So, we are going to put in order. Try to put in order the other frequency adverbs in this schedule, and in a moment we are going to check if you are right or not. Copy that in your notebook and put the other adverbs, frequency adverbs, in order. Tell me when you finish. Okay, at least we have 10 minutes of this session. Tenemos 10 minutos de esta sesión. Si no salimos, nos volvemos a conectar, por favor. Y, okay, in this case, finish to copy the note and put the frequency adverb in order, okay? In a while, we are going to check if you are right or you have some mistakes.
Finish.
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 Okay.
Finish.
Anyone else?
Finish.
Okay.
Finish.
Okay. Let's check if you are right or you have some mistakes. There is in your screen the right way that you use the frequency of it, okay? Always is something that you always do. Every day you did something, okay? Usually is something that you did most of the time. Often is something that you did sometimes, okay? A veces seguido. Okay, definition. Always, siempre. Usually, usualmente. Often, seguido. Okay? Sometimes, a veces. Yeah? Don't often, no muy seguido. Don't usually, no usualmente. Y never, jamás. Okay, if you have mistakes, si tuvieron errores, corríjanlos. And write your definition. Y escriban su definición adelante, okay? Always, siempre. Usually, usualmente. Often, seguido. Sometimes, a veces. Don't often, no muy seguido. Don't usually, no usualmente. Never, nunca. Tell me what you think. Okay, did you finish?
Yes.
Finish, teacher.
Okay.
Finish, teacher.
Perfect.
Finish, teacher.
Very good.
Finish.
Okay, we're going to check. Frequency adverbs, those frequency adverbs, always, usually, etc. we are very common in present simple, okay? We use a lot. The adverbs, not often and not usually, are negative, so we must use the auxiliary verb done or doesn't. Okay? That's why it's done often, done usually. If it were, it was a third person, he doesn't often, or she doesn't usually. Okay, be careful on that. Okay, adverbs of frequency, how do we use them? Voy a salir de sesión y regresamos, ¿ok? Veamos el siguiente tema. Nos volvemos a conectar.